Now we learn about Fourier series, and here we explain it by way of a square sound wave example. So here you have a square wave because you have voltage that's here for a duration of time, and then down at zero for a duration of time, and then up here for a duration of time, and then here. And you keep on going on until you stop playing the sound. So this voltage is put into a circuit, which is then applied to this part of the speaker. And what that does is, according to Faraday's law of induction, that circuit and that voltage makes a speaker move forward and back. So you can think of it as forward, back to zero, forward, back to zero, real fast, back and forth, vibrating like this. And it pushes the air, and that translates to us as human beings as we hear the sound. So here's the Faraday's law, just talks about this. There's an electric circuit that causes a electromotive force, and that's what causes the speaker to go back and forth. So maybe if the voltages are gradual and smooth, maybe the sound will be smooth. And if the voltages are jagged or abruptly changing, maybe the speaker will produce a sound that's more edgy. So let's see where our math comes in here. So the above graph of the square wave is the graph of a function such that one period of the function is this. It was 0 from negative pi to 0. That's 0 here. And then it was 1 from 0 to pi. So we're going to do our mathematics on this type of an interval from negative pi to pi. But it could be any kind of interval. It's just that the math works out easier on those. So the full f of x function is periodic and made from copying and pasting these 1 periods next to each other and before and on and on. So, in other words, this is your 1 period here and there. That's 1 period from negative pi to pi. And then you just copy and paste that so you have the same look again from pi to 3 pi. And then you have the same look again. And you keep on going like that. Just as if you had a sine curve from 0 to 2 pi and you copied and pasted that, here's your original. You copy and paste that 2 pi to 4 pi and before it like this. So you would get a full sine curve from this one little snippet. So our goal with Fourier series is to represent the entire copied and pasted waveform f of x with a series of cosine and sine functions. Cosines and sines are periodic, so we should be able to do it somehow. Well, Jean-Baptiste Joseph Fourier, around in this era here, you see it's getting a little bit more modern now, shows us how. So he says, if you get a periodic function f of x with period 2 pi, then it's equal to, so that equals this, a constant out in front, and a series sum of these contribution from cosines and sines. Notice as the k goes up, the k in here goes up with it, and that means that these periods are getting shorter and shorter and shorter. So as k goes on, you're adding on refinements of cosines and sines. So by the time you get to 50x, and 50x there, you know, the period is 2 pi over 50. So it's real short. Okay, and where are those aks and those bks coming from? According to Fourier, they come from these formulas here. A0 is equal to this, and that's just the average value of the function on the interval negative pi to pi. And the aks are equal to this. So you have your cosine in there, pairing up with the a's, and you have your k in there, corresponding to the k. And then the bk's, they're corresponding to sines multiplied by the f of x function. And again, the k is corresponding to this k. These ak and bk are called Fourier coefficients. Now we're going to go on to part 2 of the video.